Let's go and talk about some of the challenges that we've seen, that we're going to see in solar over time. And the first thing I want to call out, it's called the duck curve. And what the duck curve is, traditionally what we see with power generation is that it's kind of, it starts to tick up after the sun rises as folks go to work, reaches a peak, you know, so right, kind of rises throughout the day while people are at work, and then reaches a peak right after folks go home, say 6, 7, folks are home making dinner, turn on the air conditioning, all those sorts of things. What the duck curve is that middle of the day where we start to see a surge, or an increase in energy demand. Once you get a certain amount of solar into your grid, you start to see demand from your traditional energy sources, you know, whether it's hydrocarbons or otherwise, to really start going down. Because the sun goes up during the day, you reach your peak of solar production, so you don't need to use the rest of your, another energy source. But where it becomes an issue is when the sun goes down and that solar power rolls off the grid, you really have to ramp up very quickly your hydrocarbon or other energy producing sources to meet that demand. And so it's led to some complications for utilities navigating kind of had a shift between those demands, particularly with energy sources, say like coal, that are really difficult to bring on quickly intraday.
Right. Yeah, these baseload, especially coal, these baseload power generation facilities, these legacy facilities, were never intended to be able to handle these really quick surges like that, right? That's just not, they weren't really built to be able to do that. And this has been a major challenge. It really, really has. The thing with the duck curve that's interesting is that, and if you go back really 4 or 5 years ago, when this first started really becoming a major concern, especially where I live here in California, where we have a massive amount of solar, huge populations. So it's really like the perfect environment for something like the duck curve to happen and to be a problem. Batteries weren't even really on the radar as a long-term solution. But the technology has improved as global scale of manufacturing batteries has grown and the costs have come down. It's really become, you know, an interesting potential solution. I think, you know, energy storage, great big batteries, as Elon Musk has called it, has an amazing amount of power to fill this need. I think it's gotten to a point now where you have utilities that are even looking at using battery storage as a solution instead of building a peaker plant. So instead of building a small natural gas plant that can quickly surge to meet those quick peak demands, bringing in a battery storage system that's capturing power even from carbon sources. So maybe getting power from a coal plant that's charging batteries during the day, if that just happens to be your cheapest incremental source of electricity, and then using those batteries instead of a peaker natural gas plant to meet that surge demand, it's really interesting what we're seeing. So think about battery storage. In the near term, you may see battery storage getting rolled out that's not even connected to renewables. It may be connected in the short term to pulling power from a natural gas plant to meet those peak periods in demand. Over time, obviously, the long-term goal from a carbon reduction perspective is to tie it into solar and tie it into wind and capturing those resources that aren't on all the time to meet those surges in demand. So watch the battery space really closely.
Yeah, the batteries are going to be very important to store that production we have during the day. And then, as you mentioned the peaker plants for natural gas. That's yep. One of those things where as that kind of gap filler fuel, natural gas really serves a good role there, because it's really easy to turn on and get production quickly and turn off and kind of turn your production off quickly. Whereas with coal, yep. Really, it's not economic unless you run it 24/7. You could say the same for nuclear. So it's really yep. Bullish for both batteries and then for natural gas having a continued role in energy production over the long term.